We want to warn you, this video is disturbing. It captures a prison murder. 2014, inside Missouri's maximum security prison, Crossroads, near Kansas City. A prisoner slipped inside another man's cell. He springs out to attack. Another prisoner runs to join the attack. He begins stabbing the inmate, who died. The first time an officer could respond was 2.5 minutes later. This former inmate says staffing is worse today. With so many corrections officers leaving, the prisoners are taking over.
It's times in my housing unit where officers might disappear for 20 or 30 minutes, and you've got free run of a whole housing unit.
Brandy Stockton says everyone should care what's going on inside Missouri prisons. Her son is an inmate.
Drake is set for immediate release in August of 2020. He's going to be your neighbor.
She makes no excuses for her son, who was serving 15 years for second-degree robbery.
Being an advocate for my child is not justifying the crime he committed. All I'm asking for is that he be treated as a human being.
She said he was treated well in the beginning while at Jefferson City Correctional.
It's still prison. He still lives in a cell. He's just being treated like a human being inside there.
She said he was in reach of his GED before a transfer to Crossroads, where she noticed a dramatic drop in staff and, in turn, disappearing programs.
There's no classes, there's no skill set offered, there's no jobs, there's nothing.
98% of the guys and gals going into prison are going to be released. Do you want them coming back out worse than they were when they went in?
Bill Schmutz is former deputy warden at Algoa in Jefferson City.
If you don't have the staffing to operate those programs, it doesn't happen. So it basically just warehousing people.
Stockton says you cannot call that corrections.
Isn't that what they're supposed to be doing? I mean, correcting behaviors.
Along with seeing fewer staff, she notices worsening attitudes, along with diminishing hiring standards.
You can tell they're fresh out of high school. I mean, they're short-staffed. They have a billboard in Cameron, Missouri, advertising that they need help. I mean, who do they think they're going to get?
The union says the latest numbers show the department about 900 officers down, dropping dramatically, while those remaining are forced to work overtime, and the state of Missouri continues fighting a jury verdict to pay officers for every hour on the job. Look for this report on the Fox 2 app to find links to our series of investigations into Missouri's crumbling corrections. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.